Not gonna lie, was not expecting this, but it's not unwelcome or anything. It's just a little surprise. So if this is your first Culinary Crucible, here's how it works. The TLDR is that you get ingredients, make dishes, and get tokens from how well these judges like it, which is based off of several different factors. For the long version, to make dishes, you need ingredients. You'll form a team of 5 students and send them on a little journey. If you have the event-specific cards, they'll get you extra ingredients. However, this only applies to the current event, so like, only Sebek and Floyd Apprentice Chef cards give extra goods. Past Apprentice Chef cards do nothing. The thing about getting ingredients is that it takes time, and after that time has passed, you can now have the things, so you gotta wait. The procurement period can be 20 minutes, 60 minutes, 150 minutes, or 360 minutes. I generally do 60 minutes through the whole day, logging in and out, and then when I go to bed, I do the 360 one, although honestly, I'm not really hard and fast about that rule, I just kind of do whatever. You'll need pasta for every one of these dishes, so make sure you get a lot of it. That one I usually do overnight. If you feel like it's taking too long, however, you can use an item called a time winder to speed things up. It will let you skip a few minutes and shave off the total wait time, but these items are pretty rare, so keep that in mind. Also, apparently you can use gems to shave time off. I would love to tell you all that I knew this the entire time, but to be honest, I literally found out about it during the last event, so... oops. Honestly though, I wouldn't recommend doing this just because gems are precious, and while yes, the time gating in these events is bleh, if you spend gems now, that's less chances to pull on a banner you really like in the future. The other downside to procurement besides it can take a while without timers is that what you get is randomized. There have been times where I've done them and not gotten what I needed, and even if you get what you need, it might not be the right quality you needed. There's different ingredient qualities, and they're low, medium, high. They'll affect their dishes, so let's go ahead and talk about dishes in this event, at least a little briefly. There's 9 dishes for you to make, and they'll only give you 1 recipe from the start. The others you have to figure out on your own. As per usual, I'm going to tell you the dishes and ingredients because no. You can skip to the time on screen if you want to see that right now. But anyways, if you mess a dish up, it's an automatic fail and you lose those ingredients. It sucks, so I really recommend you get the recipes before the event. When you first start making dishes, it's going to be garbage. Your skill level for each dish starts at 0%, and the more you make dishes, the better you'll get at making them. And also, the ingredients you use affect your skill going up. A 1-star dish increases skill by 4%, a 2-star by 8%, and a 3-star by 12%. So it's kind of impossible to tell how many times you need to make a dish in order to get to 3 stars because it varies. It varies a lot. Because your skill level is 0, you don't want to use high-quality ingredients in your beginner dishes because it's not really going to do anything except waste your high-quality ingredients. Now, the way I'd always been taught to cook in this game is use low until 60%, medium to 80, and then switch to high. I call it the 60-80 method. However, I got recommended a better way to do it by YouTube user arandombanana520, who suggested doing 30 and 50% instead of 60 and 80. I did run a little experiment testing this, which you can watch my video on it, link will be in the iCard. But yeah, not gonna lie, the 30-50 method is way faster and I like it a lot more, to be honest. But you also can just not care and throw whatever ingredients you have into a dish because let's be real here, the time crunch and the ingredient drops bullying you are so real. Just know though, if you're throwing high quality ingredients into a dish where you don't have a high skill level, it's not gonna make you get a perfect score. It's just gonna, you might get a little bit of a higher score, but like, honestly, it's really just not gonna do anything. Once you've made a dish, it's time for it to get judged. There's a lot of factors that go into your final score, some of it you can control, some not, so I'm going to try and make this as thorough but easy to digest as possible. The factors that come into scores are your skill level, the judges, and ingredient quality. There will be a panel of 3 judges. The judges will be randomized from a pool and each has their own standards on which they'll score you. You've got your strict, okay, and chill judges, and it's basically what it says on the tin. Strict judges give lower scores than chill judges, and unfortunately you don't get a balanced panel most of the time. I and many others have had panels of all strict judges, so just realize that's a thing. The judges will give you a score of 1 to 10, 1 being awful, 10 being great, and this is where ingredients kind of come into play, so, like, okay. Let's say you have a 98% and you don't have all high-quality ingredients in a dish. You have, like, 1 or 2 medium-quality ones in there. Strict judges are probably going to take that into consideration, but chill ones most likely won't. I have had some instances where I think ingredient quality made or broke my dishes, but it's like, if you have a skill level of 15 and you use all high quality ingredients, you're not going to get a perfect score of 30, like what I mentioned before. You're still going to get a lowish score. Ingredient quality is a factor, but it feels more like nitpicking and something to worry about the higher your skill level is. As a reward for your work, you get tokens. So, recipes. There's a total of 9 dishes to make. If you want to go in completely blind, that's fine, and you can skip to the time on this screen to skip this section and hear about the new cards. I'll wait a moment. Okay, so recipe time. As per usual, I translated these names myself. They might be different in the official localization. First up, carbonara. Pasta, milk, and bacon. Chicken noodle soup. Pasta, meat, onion, carrot, consomme. Fried egg rice vermicelli. Pasta, meat, egg. Penne gratin. Pasta, meat, tomato, cheese. Pescadora bianco. Pasta, garlic, shrimp, shellfish. Ramen. Pasta, meat, onion, garlic, egg. Spaghetti donuts. Pasta, flour, and pizza sauce. And also a barf bag, because this is the grossest looking thing I've seen in this game, and the grossest food concept I've seen in a long time. If Sebek gave this to me, I would 100% complain to Malleus about it, and I would not feel bad. I would not feel bad at all. Bigodang. Pasta, egg, shrimp, bell pepper. Chicken pho. Pasta, meat, ginger. Also, I'm sorry if I didn't get the tones right on that. I'm not really used to doing the down-up tones. So, we have 2 cards, SR Sebek and SR Floyd. If you want a full meta breakdown of them, I have another video on that. But long story short, Sebek is a defense water fire unit, and Floyd is an attack fire flora card. You can earn them 1 of 2 ways. You can pull for them in the gacha, or you can purchase one of them from the event shop using the SR Limited key that you can also buy from the event shop using tokens. And that's it! Not gonna lie, I totally forgot about this event, and I'm pretty surprised we're getting it instead of New Year's, but oh well. The more Culinary Crucibles EN gets caught up on, the better. Good luck, you guys, and I'll see you later. Thank you everyone for watching, and a very special thank you to my channel members and Twitch subs. Your support helps me to continue to make these videos. If you'd like early access to my videos, consider becoming a channel member. Patrons and Ko-fi members can get my scripts early before I record them. I livestream over on Twitch every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. Thanks again, guys, and I'll see y'all later.